Hey lovelies, how are you today? I have been missing you. Obviously, I'm in a new little setup right here. I'm developing this little area here. And I just wanted to come back at you and give you some stuff. I've been trying to build the studio, get the camera stuff going and all that going. So I hope this works out well. Give me a thumbs up on this video if you like it and you like my hard work. And subscribe, like, thank you so much for all my subscribers. And oh, you guys are amazing because we are just going at 5,000 really fast. And so I'm trying to think of what am I going to do at 5,000? Do I have anything to do? So y'all can give me some suggestions below, okay? Well, I've missed you. I've had a lot of technical things I've been getting used to. You know, I told you I've been trying to learn this stuff. And in the meantime, I've been responding to your comments and somebody said, it seems like you have updated your wash day. Can you please tell me about it? Now, I thought I want to do that for you, but I don't know if I can promise that. But as you can see, it's due. I'm due a wash day. I never come up here with my hair ready, you know, not done, you know. But today, this is like, it's time to do everything. I'm going to tell you what I've been doing, and I'm going to tell you what the update is. And I have all my products here to kind of show you what I do now until I get an opportunity to show you. Okay, exactly, show you. All right, so if you're interested in that, just keep on watching. I just want to think about, let me see if there's anything I need to update you on. We're on the 3-month challenge still. Keep juicing and doing your smoothies. Comment below if you want me to videotape myself, vlog myself in the supermarket going shopping. Because some people don't know how to shop. Some people don't realize that they need to be careful what they actually put in their cart before they even come home. So I'd love to show you how I shop for snacks, how I shop for junk food, or anything, and any kind of smoothie ideas, or anything like that, okay? I have a camera-ready video booklet that I've created, that I put together on how I eat and everything. I'm wearing my dance outfit because I just videotaped another dance, and I really hope y'all join me, and kind of please support me on my other channel where I'm dancing and performing. My latest craze right now is the kizomba. I love it so much because it's a nice blend of everything that I've been doing. I have a little something I have a prayer request before I get started. Pray for me, y'all. I did hurt my knee a little, but it looks like God is blessing it, and it looks like I'm on the mend, so that's a blessing. But any prayer warriors out there, please go ahead and say a special prayer for me because it looks like it's healing, and I mean, I have to get an operation. If I do, I'll definitely let you know, okay? All right, so without further ado, I'm just gonna show you the products that I use. And of course, you know my line of products, I always use those. And I want to show you all the products that I use, all the things I use with it, and kind of talk you through it. And then you can comment below on anything that you do differently, any suggestions, anything like that, okay? Let me start now. All right, so first of all, when I showed my wash day routine part 1 through 5, first of all, I didn't have this set up and everything, and it was I had it in different chunks, but I think I did a good job. I had a lot of compliments on that. With my teaching skills, thank God, right? So I want to let you know what I'm not doing anymore. So I don't use the baking soda anymore, but I'm not saying that you should never, and I don't think you should always. I think there's a time frame where there may be a window where you may be able to at least get your hair going if you're repairing it. If you were in weeds for years like me, or if you were not really taking care of it. So there's a window that you can do to start your hydration and lift it if you have low porosity. First thing, first disclaimer. I am low porosity, okay? It has been almost a year that I have been deliberate with taking care of my hair. In the beginning, I did it twice a week because I taught class twice a week, and then I switched to teaching once a week and have an instructor for one Saturdays. That was one of the things, and then I started noticing that I got a hang of it, my hair was hydrated, and I don't know, maybe I got a little lazy, I'm not sure, but I went once a week. And I did a few changes, I tried different things for the winter because we did a 3-month winter wash and go challenge. I think I did okay. I ended up trimming at the end, so that's why I'm not able to really share with you exactly my length. I also switched out on my gel, and I was experimenting on my product, so a lot of things happened around then, so I don't know how much I can share with you with my results of my 3-month challenge, okay? But I know that there's a length. You guys can see the length, and I can see it, and it's, I just really love my hair right now. I'm just loving it so much. Okay, so this is how I do it. I start off now, and so what I did was I went from the baking soda, then I started using the Giovanni shampoo, and well, no, I started using the black African black soap, didn't like it. I felt like I was getting things with my skin. Then I went to this Giovanna shampoo, and I believe when I think of what winter time and how it was dry, I don't think that was a good time to use shampoo, because I now that I have stopped that, I now have a new shampoo that I use, or a new substitute for shampoo that I use, and I'm going to tell you that now. But I want to tell you that those were the things I went through before I got to where I am today. I have tried the tea rinse. I did a honey one, and I also tried a green tea and chamomile tea, and I really like it. I don't have to use it as much. There's so many things I'm doing that I don't, sometimes I take it and leave it. And I tried the rice water, and that's something that I'm keeping. And I tried black seed, and I don't have that with me because I think I'm done with it. But let me tell you what is a keeper as of today, April 2018, the end of April. So I started with the Rhosoul Clay, and that is my shampoo, okay? So I use Rhosoul Clay. I got this from Amazon, and all I do is these are the tools that I have here that I use. I get a bowl, and I use about 3 or 4 bowls, because I make mixtures for most of what I do, but I'm just showing you one of the bowls. So today I'm about to do this, probably in another hour, so I'm gonna do all this stuff. And I'll see if I can get my husband to videotape it, but I'm not gonna promise that because it's a lot of work and I have so many things to do. So I'm gonna talk you through it. So I pour this in here. I think I do maybe a quarter of a cup. And then I use my, I don't have it with me, I didn't bring it down, but the apple cider vinegar, you can get that at Walmart, you can get it anywhere, $6 around. And lately I've been putting apple cider vinegar and water, right? So what I used to do is I used to put some rose powder with it for moisture, and I would put some aloe vera powder with it. The aloe vera powder, I also got it on Amazon, but the rose powder, I went in my local store. And I actually have that, a lot of that myself. If you need some, let me know. And so you can put that in there to make it even more moisturizing and gentle on your hair. But lately, because I'm using this as a shampoo, I only use this, apple cider vinegar and water, warm water. What I do is I will mix it up, and then I'll get it ready. I usually get as much ready as I can. I get it ready, go take my shower. When I come back, it's very foamy and very clayish and foamy, and it starts to rise, and that's when I begin to put it on my hair. And what I do is I'll put it in the different sections. I don't know if I have my stuff with me. No, I don't. So I put it in my sections, and lately, because I've been telling you that I'm gonna work on the back of my hair, I start everything, especially if there's a treatment, on the back of my hair first. So I will part all of this back here, and I will make sure that I put it and I thoroughly put it through the back of my hair. I am no joke about doing it thoroughly pulling it through your hair and getting it in there really good. It is not a conditioner, so it doesn't always slip. It doesn't have that slip, but of all my treatments, it has the most slip. It feels great and it feels wonderful. Layla from Fusion something, I can't remember what the name of her channel is. I love her. Okay, hair crush. What I think that's where I got the idea that you can use this as soap. She does, and she scrubs her scalp with it, and I began to do that. So use this to cleanse your scalp. I'm sure many of you are already on it with saying you can pour this in there, you can pour that on there. I'm sure you can put lots of stuff in there. You could probably put tea tree, you could probably put peppermint, lavender, I'm sure. I just want to clean my hair, and this is some amazing stuff, okay? Please don't sleep on this. Rhosoul Clay. I don't like dentonite clay. I tried it, and I don't like what it does to my curl pattern, okay? So that's my wash. So now I've come out of the shower. I put that in my hair. I put a plastic bag like this on my hair. I leave it in for the level one. Lately, I've been kind of lazy doing the level, not all of them, but some of them I use the level one. Because I've been doing this for so long, my hair is kind of hydrated. I don't have to do it as long. Level one means, you've heard me say this a million times, 10 to 15 minutes. I think it's 15. Always messing up with this. I'm gonna write this down. Okay, level one is about 15 to 20 minutes. And level two is like 30 minutes to 45 minutes. And a level three is an hour up until 4 hours. Okay, so that means how much time you have to do it. So level three is like a spa day, where you really have time. And when I say that, I mean treatments. How long you put a treatment in your hair that it can make your wash day longer or shorter. And so when I first started coming into the natural hair scene, I realized that was the biggest concern, is that we have such long wash days and what, you know, but we can't do anything about it because we really need these treatments, okay? They're things you do not want to do without. You need to strengthen and moisturize and clean. and seal, and you need to protect. Those are the five. Patrice, five, remember that? So we need to shampoo clean it. We need to strengthen it. We need to moisturize it. We need to seal it, and we need to dress it with whatever we dress it with, you know, or the sealant can be the dressing. But every type of hair, low porosity, high porosity, a regular, doesn't matter. Everyone needs to do it. Doesn't matter if you're white, black, doesn't matter if you have kinky hair, straight hair. Everyone needs to be doing all that stuff. We just need it even more because we need the help of these products for the moisture. And some of us, because of the moisture, need the strengthening even more because it breaks our hair. So that's why we can't skip on it. Where other people, they can do a shampoo that has all that in there, wash and condition, and then style because the shampoo happens to have enough in it for their hair. For us, we have to deliberately do each step and make sure we give it time. That's why I say a level one would be 15 to 20 minutes in your hair where you're giving it a quick little something in there, at least 15 minutes. And then a level two would be 30 minutes to 45 minutes. So that's at least like, okay, I got a little bit more time and put some more, as much as I can put in it. And then the last one is an hour to more. Now, you can always go over that or under that, but I'm just giving you a little piece of what can help you with your time management. So if you have to do a wash day, but you don't really have a lot of time, you may have to do the level one, which is just 15 to 20 minutes of each treatment, but don't skip doing it. Okay, so that's that little. So I'm trying to pull my channel up in one for those who have followed me for the hair. I'm trying to put as much into this as I can. Try not to go too long with it. So that would be washing my hair. After I've washed my hair, then I'd start to treat my hair. And this right here is my clay. So the clay came from the oil. You can go to ayurvedacurls.com to get my oil, my clay, my conditioner, and my gel. Please follow me on my Instagram channel, which is Ayurveda Curls, and you'll get, I'm gonna be putting up more and more stuff like this, like little videos showing you how to put on my stuff. There's people up there showing you how their hair goes and everything like that. Okay, so the oil is infused with all kinds of wonderful things. I can read a few: olive oil, grape seed oil, henna, blend, amla, Jamaican black castor oil, rosemary oil, lavender, all these wonderful things, okay? And more, and then I pray over it as well. Once that's done being infused, I usually do it for 5 days. So I really put the time and love energy into it. I extract the oil from the clay, from the ingredients that I put in there, and it turns into a clay. So when you purchase this, you'll have a bag with clay in it. This is the actual ingredients that come out of the oil. This right here, I did a video, and I'll try to link it up here, what the difference, what is a gloss, what is a clay, and what is a mask, okay? So what this is going to start off as a clay for you, is right? Because it has stuff in it, so it's kind of gloss slash clay. You would need to take it and add something to it. So I take another bowl, and I will either add, lately I've been a little simple, and I just add warm water, and it's been fine, just warm water, because it has enough in it. Or you can take a conditioner. Lately, I've been using Aussie. This was my backup just in case Giovanni was the deep conditioner ran out because it was really getting ridiculous. It's a slim bottle. It's about $7 a bottle. I got that from Curly Proverbs. It was wonderful in my hair. I love it. But I just, you know, I don't have time to keep running to get it because it runs out so quickly. I still love it. But I said, when I saw and I did my research, everyone, this was the next best thing on YouTube. In terms of a slip, a regular leave-in or a regular conditioner, if you just treat detangling and stuff, just a basic conditioner. Everyone seemed to love this, and it wasn't expensive, so I've been having it as my backup for a while. Now I'm using it. So you can put this in your mask when you get it, clay when you get it, and it is, it's a clay mask. It's like both. So it's called an Ayurveda Hair Clay Mask. It's a premium blend, because I have some premium blends in there, and you can put this in it. You can put banana. You can put avocado. You get to take this and do whatever you think you want to do with it, but make sure it's natural and it fits what we do on our channel, that natural, I suggest. Otherwise, you can just use warm water and that's it, okay? You can put my conditioner, but I just want you to use my conditioner separately just because it has its own strength in it that's wonderful. So it has its own stuff. So here's the clay. You put it in a bowl, put warm water, or you can put the clay, all that stuff in it. And you do the same thing, level one, level two, or level three. This is also a treatment, so you can pick which level you'd like to do it. Lately, I've been doing level one, which is 15 minutes. Actually, sometimes I'll just get lost watching stuff on, you know, TV or whatever, and it goes longer. Okay, so now I've washed my hair. I've I have given it this treatment. This would have been where a protein treatment or a strengthener would have been. I did that. After I've done that, now it's time to condition my hair. This is my conditioner. It's the Patrice Evans Deep Conditioning Honey Mask. Honey is the main thing that I have in my conditioner. It has manuka honey, amla, aloe vera power. It's the same stuff that I did in my channel, but of course I pray in it and I put a few other special ingredients that are a little secret for to promote hair growth in there, okay? So it smells really good. What you would do with this one, oh, I love it so much. You would put this in hot water because it's really thick, you don't have honey in there. Put it in hot water, warm it up. Use another bowl. Use another bowl. I'll get that in a second. And really warm it up. This could be warming up when you're setting all your stuff up. You could be getting your clay ready. You could get your mask ready. Get it all ready. You know, have it sitting in hot water. Get everything all ready. Or you can wait till you're getting to your doing your next the step right before it to be sitting in warm water. But just kind of warm it up. After you've warmed it up, not too much, but just a little bit to loosen it up. Then go ahead and do the same thing you did with the mask, because this right here is also a mask. This is a mask. Mask meaning you will blend this with something. You could take your favorite conditioner and blend it with that, because this doesn't have that slip. So if you want the slip, because it's a mask, you want to put something with it just like you do with this. So you can put, I would suggest that you just take another conditioner or anything that you think has a nice slip to it to go along with it. And leave that in your hair for 15 minutes or 10 to 15 minutes. You can do it for 30 to 45 minutes, or you can do the hour. If you really think you need conditioning now, you do not never want to skip your deep conditioning. So this may be the one where you do the hour or the 45 minutes, because we need that hydration. We need it. Now, what you're gonna do when you do, let me back up a little bit. Whenever you're doing your treatments, you want to have a plastic bag over your head. This is what I did. And then I sell these thermal steamers. They're called thermal steamers because they're not the kind of steamer that steams out water. They're actually like a spa, okay? And this is where how it'll come to you. It's not very expensive. They're really good quality. They have a zipper so you can take this plastic out and wash it. They have coils in there and the heat comes. You put it over your head, you take this little pulley thing, you pull it in, and then you turn it on with the little plug thing here. Plug works really, really well, and I've fought for you guys to make sure I give you the best product that I can. This is, I think, $16 on AyurvedaCurls.com, and so definitely wear this, put it in there. This is what you're going to sit in for 15 minutes, or the 30 to the 45 minutes, or the hour, or whatever you do. You're going to sit in this. This will be the thing that you're going to need in order to really get this to penetrate in your hair, right? So now you've done your treatments. You've done your clay. First, you washed it with the Rhosoul Clay. You've done this treatment here. That's what I would have done. Then I would have done this treatment. Now my hair is feeling really good between the one, two, three things already. You've already now done the real work that you need to do on your hair, okay? I didn't talk about pre-poo yet, but I'll get to that. After you've done that, you've done with using this, you put this away. You're gonna wash this out. So you wash the clay out. Then you're gonna put this in. Then you're gonna wash the clay mask out. So you're washing the Rhosoul clay out. Then you're gonna put in the clay mask from the oil, the henna lint mask. And then you're gonna keep that in and wash that out with warm water. Everything's warm water so far. I sometimes use hot, you know me. Then I do this, leave that in, wash that out with warm water. There's still gonna be little gritty things. So even after you've washed this out, you're going to probably need to put some of your favorite leave-in. Now, at this step, this is where lately I've been putting my rice water. Look how nasty that looks. Yeah, it's nasty. I ain't gonna open it. But that's the rice water. And this is my dance outfit, so bear with me that I'm wearing this. This is where some people on YouTube, they put the rice water in one of these and they spray it in the hair. So you've done the three things. You've washed it, you've done your henna clay, you've done your mask, and now you rinse everything out and now you're gonna put your rice water. I take this and I even leave the rice in there. I'm not getting crazy. And I just douse it over my head, over the tub, maybe one or two pieces of rice balls in there. And guess what I do? I put more water back in it, close it up, and put it right back until the next day. I keep reusing the same rice for at least a few times before I get rid of it. That's what I've been doing, okay? Because I just don't have time to be running up and down stairs forever. I have a cinnamon stick in there, and then I put my oil in there also to blend in there, and then I do that. So that's with the rice water. So the rice water comes after you've done your conditioner. Now, you can leave that in there for 10 minutes, okay? So now you've done that, and after you've left that in there for 10 minutes, then you rinse that out with cool water, okay? Once you're done with the rice, you're rinsing that with cool, now you're closing your cuticles, okay? Once you rinse it out, make sure it doesn't stink, rinse it. Now you can go in with your leave-in conditioner, which I now realize you must have a leave-in. You need something. I do a conditioner and I don't rinse it out. Okay, I just rinse a tiny bit out, but I put a little bit of conditioner in my conditioner. You need the slip because we did a lot of masks, okay? And you need some kind of slip. So go ahead and get your favorite leave-in and get that store-bought. I really like this. Then it's the fun part, my favorite things. Oh, I love my oil. Y'all know I love my oil. That's how y'all met me, because I was going crazy about how much I love my oil. I'm looking over here, not over here. I apologize. All right, here is the famous growth oil. The Patrice Evans Ayurveda Growth Oil. It's a premium blend. It's got some amazing things in it. You've already put it in as a clay. Now you're gonna double put it in there. This is going to seal your hair. So what I've done it that's new, because I've been working on the back of my hair, is I've been adding shea butter. This is the raw shea butter that I've been using, okay? It is from out of Africa, raw shea butter. It is not yellow. Okay, and I love the smell of it. Oh, it smells so good. So what I'll do is I will get like a little bit of it. I get like this much of it. Not that much, I hope you can see that. And I put it in my hands like that. And then I take some oil and I pour it in and I start to rub it in really, really well. So anyway, I put this together, I wrap it up. I mix it up really, really well. And then right? You can do it just with this, but what I've been trying to do is, remember the back of my hair, I'm trying to give it my most problem area, I'm trying to give it more love, so I've learned that that works. And so what I ended up doing was I started just doing here, and then because the winter was taking forever to go away, I ended up putting all my hair, and it wasn't bad, I wasn't having a problem, so I was like, you know, shea butter is good for your hair, so I ended up keeping that. And then when I'm done with that, I'll put a little bit more water on my hair, right? And then I go in with my styling jam. I have been through so many of these, guys. I love my styling jam. And it's my daughter's using it, and it actually stretches her hair out. So if you have looser curls to begin with, right, and they don't have a lot of kink, it actually stretched her hair out. It's really pretty. If you go into my Ayurveda curls Instagram page, you'll see some pictures of how this is being used and how beautiful it is on the model's hair, okay? All right, now, what I do is I rinse my hair. I put a little water on my hair, and then I take a nice amount of this, a good quarter amount, you see. What I do, though, is I don't really pour it out of the tip. I actually just take it out like this and pour it in because it's kind of thick, and I get a nice amount, a good quarter amount. I don't know if you can see that. And what I do is, this is mine, I'm not selling this to anybody, I got all my products over here that I use all the time. And then I take that amount and I just put it in the back of my hair, all in here, make sure it's really in there good. I comb it with my fingers like I did with the other one, still do that. And then I do another section, then I start to do all my sections. I've noticed that it slips much better if I have a leave-in. If I don't have a leave-in, it doesn't slip as much well, and that's where I can get some breakage if I am rushing or whatever. And after that, then I pin my hair. And when I was doing twist outs for a while because I was really concerned about the back of my hair and pins. And then I did a doobie. I didn't like the way that looked. Guess what? I'm back to pinning the way I did before, but what I'm doing is using less pins back there. I like the way my hair came out when I used my pin. And I took this part, swooped it back like this and pinned it. I swoop it around to the front and pin it. Then I take these parts and go across and pin them, and then I take my bang and go all the way back. I've been wearing this hairstyle just to give my hair a break from stretching it and everything. One more new thing that another thing is, that I use is, I love the towel that I sell at ayurvedagirls.com. I love it. It's been washed already once, but this is what it comes in. It's a really cute little bag, and this is what it is. So a lot of the products that I sell, I actually use. The only other ones that I don't use is this conditioner, the apple cider, the Rhosoul Clay, and of course, you know, the powder and the rosemary. Then I wrap my hair with a silk scarf, a satin scarf, or if I'm going to bed with this kind of hairstyle, I'll do a bonnet. And that is my new updated wash day. I hope that helped you. As a pre-poo, I have been using black seed oil, and I've used rice rinse, I've used the tea, and I always seal it with my oil, okay? So, and I would do that like this would be a pre-poo. I would do it like the day before. I won't do my hair that night, give myself a break. Instead, I'll just wash it, and then rinse all the junk off, whatever I have left, whatever gel I have on it or whatever, and then I will put my pre-poo, my oils in my hair, always focusing on the hair with their treatment, and then I will always seal it with my oil and either put a cap and sit under the thermal steamer, or I will just make it into a hairstyle like this where people can't tell that I'm actually doing that. I have oils all in my scalp, and I'm walking around at night, it's put in, and then when I wake up the next day, I'll just let the oils be my gel, and that's how I do it. Well, that's it, and I'm so happy to be able to bring this to you. If you need more, I will do my best to help you. Otherwise, I'm so glad that I'm able to update it and let you know what I do. I'll be working hard to figure out if I can give you videos showing you how I do it all, but I'm glad I can do this. Please support me and take care of your hair and while supporting a black business. And try out, if you are already looking for something, you were gonna buy it anyway, why don't you try out my product line, Patrice's product line. It's on ayurvedagirls.com. Many of you have already tried it. I've had reorders, so that means it must be working great. I'm seeing some great feedback, lots of emails and everything. Some of you, it's time for you to reorder. So I hope you try it. It's something God, you know, you guys asked me for it. I worked hard and got it done. And I pray over everything, and I'm always praying for you. So always keep Jesus a part of your journey and be deliberate with taking care of your hair and yourself. And I hope you guys are doing well on the 3-month challenge, all right? Drink a lot of water and get that blood circulating through your 3-month, do your week inversion methods and all that good stuff, okay? And one last tip, treatments are something you do once in a while. This you can do once a week and twice a week. All of this, okay? This is something to do regularly. Love you guys. Bye. Check out the Patrice Evans page and watch my performances. Share it. If you know somebody who loves dancing or who's in the industry that wants to see a beautiful dance or something, help me out and share it with me. Okay? Love you. Bye.